Welcome back. Now, one of the best ways to make money is having your own employment, especially the organic kind. But what's better is having the kind of employment where you're able to have an entire value chain and benefit from each of the stages. In Biharo is one such cattle keeper and farmer who has been able to benefit through interconnecting his cattle farm and the banana plantation, where he uses the cow dung for manure and also uses parts of the banana plants for his cows to feed on. We have his story.
I'm called Otega Daniel Kajira. I'm a farmer. My farm is called Avato Dairy Farm. We mainly focus on dairy farming, and the former director was late Kajira. D. Kajira is a retired captain, and he joined into farming, and now I'm the one who manages the farm as their last born son, and we're doing farming as a family business, and we mainly focus on dairy cows, Frisians, and we have started having Frisians and other exotic breeds as a farm. We have some few challenges, and one of the challenges is diseases in cows, East Coast fever. East Coast fever, foot and mouth disease, drought. Like in Uganda, we have challenges of drugs. Drugs are a bit, they have affected them, but we are looking for a way we can use other companies so that they can give us good drugs. And I'm also a member of one of the biggest cooperatives in Uganda. It's called the West Ghana Kashai Dairy Farmers Cooperative Society, and it is in here in Biharwe. The size of my farm is located in Biharwe, Renjeru. It's on 110 acres, and we have banana plantations, we have a mango project. We also have dairy cows. So we collect milk, we milk cows. After milking the cows, we take them to the cooperative. One of the biggest cooperative, West Ghana Kashai Dairy Farmers Cooperative Society. And that is where we collect milk from all the members in Kashari. So we are comprised of about 180 members. We get products, we collect milk and market it and sell them to the one of the processors. We have also started processing yogurt as a value addition, and we are planning to also have a market size where we can also sell our milk, our yogurt, every part of Uganda. So we're trying that. As a farm, we are trying to also have a big quantity of milk, because now we have around 250 liters of milk per day, and we are planning also to increase on the milk so that we can also compete with other farmers. Our dairy cows, first of all, we have planted hay. We have planted sugar napier. We cut them, make silage, make hay. We have as hay, we make Chorus Diana, and Chorus Diana, we make them hay. We store them so that we can supplement them. We supplement our cows. We give them minerals, vitamins, so that they can increase on their milk production and also be healthy. And give them fresh water. We have big troughs where we can store water from, so that they can, the water that we use is a bit fresh, not like the ones which we use in the dams. The dams and other troughs which are made by clay, no, we don't use that. We use well-furnished, well-made troughs. We have 100 cows, plus the calves, plus the heifers, 110 cows. And we are planning to increase on the cows by making zero grazing. We want to make it a modern farm. We want to start zero grazing, and we are planning in about 3 to 2 years we are going to start a modern farm. So far it's now modern, but we haven't reached on the stage that we want, so we are planning to structure the farm and make it a modern farm where even people can learn from it, because it's near the city and it is strategically located very well. Diversification is very good because you cannot depend on one thing. You cannot depend on dairy farming. So we also planned that we can also have mangoes and banana plantation that can also support the dairy farm. Because when you have your manure, you take it to the banana plantation, and the banana plantation also gives you income so that you can also support the dairy farm. It's good to diversify, and I encourage everyone to diversify. If you have like a farm that has a land, you can try to diversify, do farming, do plantations, so that everything can come with an income, so that you can also support if the production of milk is low, then the banana plantation can help you to pay the workers and people who will, the helpers that help you at the farm. The cow dung that is got from the cows, we take it to the mangoes and to the banana plantation, because this one helps them into manure, right? It gives it nutrition for the banana plantations, and we also, if it becomes a lot, there are some people who want it, who want the cow dung, so we sell them the cow dung. So it's seasonal. There is a time where you take it to the banana plantation, and there is a time when you sell off your cow dung. Longhorn cattle are good. But our main focus was dairy production. We wanted to yield milk, because Frisians and other exotic breeds increase a yield of production of milk. So our main focus was Frisian, because we thought that we can increase on our milk production because of income. That is, because when you yield a lot of milk, that is the income that you get. So it's better. We have Ankole cows, but they are not on this farm, but they are on the other farm. But we are mainly focusing on this farm as a dairy productive farm. Our impact on the farm, on the environment, we have given people employment, we have given people jobs. Other people are working, our neighbors, most of them working to the banana plantation, and they get what to eat. The others are working two cows, and they get what to eat. So that is the impact that we have given them. We have also given them a good environment, because we maintain our trees, and we give them also oxygen for their sustainability. So we also we have impacted on the good environment to keep the environment clean, and we are trying to also work with the government on roads, on other things, so that we can also try and keep the environment clean. One of the challenges that we are facing is on the farm is diseases. We have got an outbreak of East Coast fever this season. The other season we had foot and mouth disease. Those are one of the challenges that we have gotten. We also have a challenge of milk price. Our milk price is a bit fluctuating, and it fluctuates a lot, and it doesn't help us as a farmers, because when you yield some milk and you give it to the dairy, they give you little price, and which cannot sustain our farms. So I don't know how we can we are trying to market our prices, but now we have tried to do value addition, but it's still low. So our processors are, the prices are fluctuating, and it's a challenge for the farmers. And we encourage, maybe they can increase our prices so that we can sustain our farms.
Use record keeping to know how my farm stands, the milk production record, the herd, the cows, how many cows are on the farm, how many cows have we have lost, because it keeps us moving to know how the farm has gone and how the cows are how the farms are reproducting, because if you know that the cow is about it has six calves, or maybe it has produced more than six cows, so you can know how you can try to maintain it so that you cannot it cannot be old, so you know how to know that these cows are productive, this cow is productive. We do bucket feeding system, so we know how much this calf has taken. This calf, how much we have to see how months, how if it takes 6 months, and we know that that is when we'll remove it on the bucket feeding. I tell all the urban viewers about dairy farming. I want to tell you that everything is tiresome, but you have to try. And if you want to venture into dairy farming, you have to be patient. You have to learn the breeding, the health of cows. You have to also learn on the production of milk, how you can increase on your milk. You have to have a land. That is one of the important things. Land is very important on farming. You have to also know which breeds you're going to use, because breeding is very important in dairy farming. And also, you have to not be a mobile farmer. You have to be on farm so that you can also monitor on how you can maintain your farm and make it a better farm.
Now you realize that for every business you start, it's always crucial to make sure that you're benefiting from every single stage of your input. Let's move on to our personal finance, where after Christmas spending, there is most likely going to be a hole in your pocket, but it does not have to be that bad, because here we bring you simple ways to save money in a new year.
Simple ways to save money in a new year. 1. record your expenses. The first step to start saving money is to figure out how much you spend. Keep track of all your expenses. That means every coffee, household item, and cash tip. Once you have your data, organize the numbers by categories such as gas, groceries, and mortgage, and total each amount. Use your credit card and bank statements to make sure you're accurate and don't forget any. 2. Budget for savings. Once you have an idea of what you spend in a month, you have to begin to organize your recorded expenses into a workable budget. Your budget should outline how your expenses measure up to your income so you can plan your spending and limit overspending. Be sure to factor in expenses that occur regularly but not every month, such as car maintenance. Include a savings category. Aim to save 10-15% of your income. 3. Find ways you can cut your spending. If your expenses are so high that you can't save as much as you would like, it might be time to cut back. Identify 9 essentials that you can spend less on, such as entertainment and dining out. Here are some ideas for trimming everyday expenses. Cancel subscriptions and memberships you don't use, especially if they renew automatically. Commit to eating out only once a month and trying places that fall into the cheap eats category. 4. Set savings goals. One of the best ways to save money is to set a saving goal. Start by thinking of what you might want to save for. Perhaps you are getting married, planning a vacation, or saving for retirement. Then find out how much money you will need and how long it might take you to save it. And 5. Decide on your priorities. After your expenses and income, your goals are likely to have the biggest impact on how you allocate your savings. Be sure to remember long-term goals. It's important that planning for retirement doesn't take a backseat to shorter-term needs. Tip: learn how to prioritize your savings goals so you have a clear idea of where to start saving. For example, if you know you're going to need to replace your car in the near future, you could start putting money away for one now.
Well, with that, you can be able to survive the heat of January, but also the months to come. Let's now take a look at the Forex and Money Market Report. We have come to the end of the show tonight, and as the economy reopens, we hope that you can watch the business show every Thursday 10 p.m. and that is to help you learn the news happening in the business world, the know-how and information from experts to be able to thrive in your new business but also improve your old business. Thank you so much once again for making time. I'll see you next week, same time. Good night.